2020 is right around the corner, and there's no better time than now to secure all your devices with NordVPN. Not only with their virtual private network infrastructure, but also with their encryption that will secure all of your data and make sure nobody has access to it but you. Right now, use the code Geekdom or go to nordvpn.com/geekdom and you'll get 70% off a 3-year plan and not 1 but 2 months for free. Recently, Nord has been very proactive in improving their security even more than it already is by now working with cybersecurity leaders and doing a full-scale audit to assess hardware, software, code, architecture, and more. Try it out, nordvpn.com/geekdom. When I first started the transformation guide, the most requested video that I got was this one right here, Super Saiyan 4. It's kind of funny that a lot of folks slag on GT, but they love this form. This transformation is so popular among Dragon Ball fans, and surprisingly so. But finally, as promised, we have it here. The transformation guide talking Super Saiyan 4 begins next. Now, the previous transformation guide that I released covered the Golden Uzaru Golden Great Ape Form, and I want to tell you that you probably are best suited to watch that one first. So if you have not seen that one, definitely go watch it and then come back to this video, because to me, they both go hand in hand. They're both kind of mirroring each other. Super Saiyan 4 was Dragon Ball GT's evolution of the Saiyan transformation beyond what we saw in Dragon Ball Z. As I said in my Truth About GT video, Toriyama was involved in the early creative process behind GT, but as the series progressed, he was less and less involved. And because of this confusion that happened for so many years, a lot of fans believe that Super Saiyan 4 was designed by Toriyama, but it was not. He had no input whatsoever into this transformation based on every interview we've seen about GT. On the contrary, Super Saiyan 4 was designed by longtime Dragon Ball character designer and key animator Katsuyoshi Nakatsuru. And Nakatsuru was an absolute beast when it came to emulating Toriyama's style and one of the best artists that they ever had work on Dragon Ball. And he is the one who designed SS4. In fact, the first time, and to my knowledge, only time that Toriyama actually drew Super Saiyan 4 was for the Dragon Ball GT Dragon Box DVD release that would come out many years after GT was already over with. So this form, Toriyama really did nothing with it. It's Nakatsuru's baby, and yet it's still so beloved among fans. And I think the reason why it's so beloved is because of how different it is from the other Super Saiyan forms, not just in overall design, but also in how Goku attained the form. As Dragon Ball GT progressed, the writers had to come up with a higher and higher level of power, and Super Saiyan 3 was not cutting it. In fact, Goku battled Baby Vegeta and could not get the job done with Super Saiyan 3. As I said in the Golden Uzaru video, the Kais found a way to kind of tap into the Secret Saiyan power, and we saw Goku become a Golden Uzaru by taking a tremendously high amount of Brutes waves and becoming a Great Ape. And then what happened was, he was totally out of control. Once he was able to gain control thanks to his love for his granddaughter, he mutated one more time, controlled his body, and became Super Saiyan 4. Now, what's really interesting about this form is, like I said, how different it looks. You grow red fur on your body. You have dark hair, kind of long, but not as long as SS3. You have mysterious magical pants that happen to grow. And the most important thing to me is that with the case of Goku, he was a kid throughout the majority of GT. And when he went into SS4, he went back into being adult Goku. And I'll be honest, I think part of the reason as to why fans love this form is because they were getting sick of Kid Goku, to be real with you, at least Kid Goku in GT. Now, the lore behind Super Saiyan 4 to me has always been interesting because, like I said in the Golden Great Ape video, it's implied that the Golden Great Ape is the truest form of Legendary Super Saiyan, but it cannot be controlled. So thus, Super Saiyan 4 is sort of like a controlled version of Golden Great Ape, except the level above it, the mutation above it. And there's been a theory for years that the original Super Saiyan forms 1, 2, and 3 are just gradual mutations to eventually get to this form. However, it's pretty clear and obvious that you do not have to achieve Super Saiyan 3 to get Super Saiyan 4, contrary to what Funimation may have said in interviews back in the day. No, you don't have to have SS3 to get SS4. Why? Because Vegeta didn't have to do it. However, Vegeta's way of getting Super Saiyan 4 was a little bit of cheating, to be honest with you. He had Bulma create a machine that fires a high concentration of Brutes waves right into your body, and then Vegeta became an ape, became a golden great ape, and then controlled himself quickly to become Super Saiyan 4. And then from there, when Goku and Vegeta fused to make Gogeta, Gogeta 4 in Dragon Ball GT was already in Super Saiyan 4 from the start. Now, a lot of fans have theorized as to why Gogeta has red hair in GT. And the reality is, you can have a million theories about it, but it's never been explained to this day as to why Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta has red hair. It looks cool. It's not like a preview of Super Saiyan God or whatever theory people might have, because Toriyama and the writers behind GT had no idea that they were ever going to do SS God. This is literally a decade or so before Battle of Gods even happened. But Goku would achieve this form in Dragon Ball GT Episode 34. Vegeta would get it in Dragon Ball GT Episode 59. And then there's Gogeta, who only made one appearance in Dragon Ball GT, and that is GT Episode 60. But that's a fusion, not really a transformation, but hey, I love going back and watching how powerful Gogeta was. In fact, I did a Strongest in Dragon Ball video on Gogeta 4. How much of a beast, you ask? Well, Goku used Super Saiyan 4 for pretty much the remainder of Dragon Ball GT to battle all of his foes. And he made a joke out of Baby Vegeta in humanoid form and was even able to defeat Golden Great Ape Baby Vegeta. Obviously, he had some help for this fight, but he still was able to do it in this form. For some reason, Dragon Ball Wiki lists Goku's alternate upgraded version of this form as Full Power Super Saiyan 4. Now, Full Power Super Saiyan 4 is not an official transformation. It's not even its own transformation at all, so I'm not really sure why they list it as that, but basically, a bunch of Goku's friends and family donated their energy to Goku to power him up in order to beat Baby Vegeta. That is Full Power Super Saiyan 4. But again, it's not its own transformation. That would be like saying that when Goku took energy from the Z Fighters in the first Broly movie to beat Broly, that's a different Super Saiyan form. And it's not. I mean, nobody says that. It's the same thing here. Now, I should mention that once somebody taps into Super Saiyan 4, you don't have to repeat the process again of getting the Brutes waves or staring at the moon or any of that stuff. Once you get the form the first time, your brain adapts and you can transform into it whenever you want, which is pretty handy. And when you really think about it, this form is so powerful that a child's body cannot maintain the power. It transforms you into an adult. And to me, that's always interesting because if you remember, Goku became a kid because of a wish to the Black Star Dragon Ball. So that means that Super Saiyan 4 is so powerful, it's able to temporarily nullify the wish from the dragon of the Black Star Dragon Balls. To me, that's always been really interesting and something that I wonder if they even thought through when they came up with. Now in GT, the signature attack that Goku comes up with for Super Saiyan 4 is the 10 times Kamehameha, which is basically 10 times stronger than the traditional Super Kamehameha. And I love how the beam is red, matching with the red fur of the form. It's a cool little design trick that I really enjoyed that the GT staff came up with. Now, contrary to Super Saiyan 3, Super Saiyan 4 does not have a stamina problem or really any problem. The form uses a lot of power. It is extremely powerful and it definitely upgrades your speed, stamina, your endurance, everything. You become an absolute monster when you're in this form. However, we do find out that it does shorten the fusion time because of how much power it has. So Gogeta was only able to be fused for 10 minutes instead of the 30 minutes because, well, the writers had to come up with some way to make Gogeta not win. Even though it's kind of weird that that happened, it somewhat makes sense because of how much power it is putting out and the instability of Metamorin Finger Fusion. Also, there's a misconception out there when it comes to Super Saiyan 4 that it's equally powerful to the Golden Great Ape except controlled, and that is not true. Super Saiyan 4 is much stronger than the Great Ape form, but a lot of that may have to do with the fact that Goku's mind, body, and ki are all aligned, and thus he knows how to fully use that power. That could be why that is, but I still am willing to say that it's way stronger, because look at what it does. I mean, look how strong it is just watching GT. Now, for more information on this form, we can go to the GT Perfect Files guidebooks that give us a bit more information. They discuss in the guidebooks that When Goku's in Golden Uzaru, he gains what's referred to as a human heart or a compassionate heart, and the result is the birth of the mightiest of warriors, Super Saiyan 4, who combines reason with tremendous power. That was in the book, of course. Now, in the GT Perfect Files, they also discuss the whole 1,000 years, you know, prophecy or whatever the case is, the legend that Vegeta talks about in Dragon Ball Z, with how it relates to this form. And it's very interesting because there's a paragraph there that implies that only pure-blooded Saiyans can reach this form based on the fact that when Goku first got Super Saiyan, other half-breeds were able to do it shortly after that, so the legend was kind of seen as being not true or kind of overhyped, whereas Super Saiyan 4 may actually be the legendary power, or at the very least, Golden Uzaru. But of course, that got somewhat nullified when the video games, and of course, we're talking about just the video games here, gave the form to Gohan. Gohan most likely can never do Super Saiyan 4. However, the video games did give the forms to Broly and Bardock, who are both purebloods. But remember, in early Dragon Ball Z, even though Gohan's a half-breed, he was still able to become a great ape. So theoretically speaking, Gohan maybe can reach it. It's up to you to decide how you want to feel about it, but it is implied that it's a form strictly for purebloods, but not outwardly stated. Now, speaking of the GT Perfect Files, there's an article in there comparing Super Saiyan 4 to Vegito that a lot of Dragon Ball fans have really got confused. So a lot of Dragon Ball fans think that Vegito is equal to Super Saiyan 4, and that's not exactly what was said. The actual translation from Herms goes as follows. After Goku and Vegeta use a merging item to merge, they become Vegito. They can furthermore become a Super Saiyan, making them Super Vegito. After two strongest people merge, they become the greatest master in the universe, perhaps even stronger than Super Saiyan 4. The fact that it says perhaps even stronger means it's possible, but whoever wrote this does not want to commit to saying that it's stronger, maybe because they're worried about power scaling debates in Japan or among the Toei offices. I have no clue why they wrote it like that, but he's guessing that Vegito could be stronger than Super Saiyan 4. And while I do think that is a possibility, I feel like the way Goku got stronger and stronger in the series, maybe Vegito is stronger than Super Saiyan 4 during the baby fight, but possibly not the case by the end of GT, where Goku's fighting the dragons and it seems to be a lot stronger. But again, I leave that up to you. I never put too much stock in that quote. A lot of folks do. To me, it's not that important. Either way, this is Goku's most powerful form in the original run of the anime, from Dragon Ball to Z to GT. Not talking about Super, just those original shows that ran from 1986 to 1997. Super Saiyan 4 is peak power. Anyways, that is it for this edition of the Transformation Guide. I really hope you enjoyed it and had a lot of fun. I love digging up this information, and yeah, thank you for watching. I love you, and I hope to see you soon.